Okay, so the UFC. Ugh. This one's bad. This is a big lawsuit. This one's been going on for a little while. Like I said, this one started, I think, back in 2014. This was a number of fighters. I think it was six to start. But it's listing as many as 1,200 fighters may now be involved because there's a time period of when this takes place, this class action lawsuit. I'm going to read it so it'll give the information rather than spew out the information that I think I know and I probably do know. It'd just be easier for me to go ahead and read it. So here we go. So this is from Sports Keeda. I've caught articles from these guys before and they're okay. I don't know. It's not bad. The information's pretty good in comparative to other articles anyway. So breaking UFC antitrust lawsuit certified as class action after damning federal court verdict. 1,200 fighters now involved. So the UFC is reportedly being sued by over 1,200 fighters for allegedly using illegal business practices. So that's misleading. They're not being sued by over 1,200 fighters. There are 1,200 fighters that could be a part of this lawsuit. It started with six. It's probably grown since then. I don't know how many are in there now, and I'm sure when they see the dollar amount that could be involved in this settlement or I mean this lawsuit, and probably subsequent settlement. Let's be real. The UFC is probably not going to go to court. They'll just settle over this. I'm sure a bunch of these, sort of no-name fighters, people maybe you've heard of or whatever, maybe they've been on undercards or something, never really did much. They're going to jump in this because of that time period I said. So over the past few years, the Ultimate Fighting Championship has acquired mainstream attention through their partnership with ESPN. The added viewership has led to backlash from some fans who believe the fighters aren't paid properly. That's kind of a misnomer, but anyways, according to Eric Magrican, a combat sports regulatory lawyer, a group of fighters started a class action lawsuit against the worldwide leader in MMA nearly 10 years ago. The legal action was certified today. Now this is dated back a few days, August 9th. Explained the situation by Twitter by saying, in a nutshell, a bunch of fighters sued the UFC saying they used illegal techniques to acquire dominance in the market, and they abused that dominance in the market, and the effect has been to underpay fighters drastically over the years. So the fighters associated with the lawsuit were not revealed, but there are reportedly at least 1,200 involved. Again, they're saying that. That's not 100% true. That just means that there could be that many. It's like when they do these class action lawsuits and they reach out to someone and they go, were you affected by X? And so not everybody gets into the class action lawsuit. They actually have to opt in or they can opt out either way, but they have to opt in. They're not just opted in on their own. But there are reports. Okay, so the exact timeline has been confirmed for what's next in the legal action. So here we go. In order to get certification for the class action lawsuit, a group of fighters suing the Ultimate Fighting Championship would need substantial evidence. After 10 years of advocating, the union has convinced the court that the next step should be taken. So these are really damning reasons the court released today. They found a preponderance of evidence that the UFC has used ruthless and coercive practices. In a nutshell, there's three things the court said. So here we go. Number one, they used oppressive contracts. Number two, that they use ruthless tactics outside of their oppressive contracts and combine those with two things: keep fighters from really ever enjoying free agency. Okay. And three, the court found that the UFC has brought up com or has bought up competition, not to necessarily make their product better, but instead to give fighters fewer choices on the open market. I would kind of agree with that last one. I think that last one, they probably did that a lot at the start. And one could make arguments that they were breaking anti-monopoly rules, or even there's another one, I forget what it's called, like monopsony or something like that. It's a market term or something. I think it refers to it maybe in this article, but oh, probably not. Looks like this article's over. Okay, so anyways, so in to sum that sort of up, right now it was so this lawsuit had been going on for a while, and essentially, they were appealing. UFC was appealing this, so it was getting kicked. The can was getting kicked down the road for the last bunch of years. But now a judge has actually said, no, that we're actually going to see this. We're gonna see this as an actual litigation. So it's moved to the next stage essentially. So, and from what I've read, it looks like it could be anywhere as far as the lawsuit could. I think it's kind of in flux right now. I think they're kind of figuring out the number, what they're going to be suing for. I don't know where they come up with the number, but somewhere between 800 million and like 1.6 billion. And it could be higher depending, I guess, on the amount of people that opt in on the class action lawsuit. I don't know how this works exactly. I don't know why the big range, but that seems to be the range anyway. So like I said, I think this is probably going to be one of those things where Dana White and the UFC will settle. And it, I mean, it's not good either way. If they have to settle, it sets kind of a, you know, it opens a door, I guess, to other fighters doing this. But I think before they settle, I think they're going to shore up anything. Well, like I said, this lawsuit, it actually, it's between the timeline of 2010 and 2017. So it has a window. Now, I don't know if maybe they shored up things because they were being sued from 2014. So now any other class action lawsuits wouldn't sort of hold the same weight. I don't know exactly. I'd have to do a little more deep diving on that. But that's where we're at right now with this. So this is like the first sort of kink in the UFC armor. They've been pretty good at keeping a pretty tight business. And amid all the sort of idea that they're underpaying fighters. Now, maybe they're underpaying certain fighters, but I don't think they're underpaying all fighters. I think some of the top fighters are pretty happy with their pay. But we'll see how this goes. I think this could be kind of bad for the UFC.